Hi, I'm Dr. Persaud, and welcome to my kitchen. Today we are talking about superfoods. You probably have heard about superfoods all over the social media and newspaper nowadays. What are superfoods? Superfoods are foods which are rich in nutrients. They help to promote weight loss. They have a lot of antioxidants and can help to prevent cancer. So ideally, I would recommend for you to not eat processed food. If you're eating something that you have to open a wrapper to get the food out of, it probably has a lot of chemicals in it and is already processed with lots of preservatives. On the other hand, you want to try to eat fresh fruits and vegetables. Amongst those fresh fruits and vegetables are superfoods. Many of the superfoods we already know, such as kale and avocados, but there's a lot that we aren't quite familiar with. Those are the ones I'm going to go over with you today. First off, we're going to start with quinoa. Quinoa. This is a white quinoa, but it also comes in a red form as well. You would use quinoa the way you would use rice. You boil it, and the actual quinoa grain becomes almost translucent, and it has like a crescent moon around it. That's how you know it's done. You treat quinoa the way you would treat regular rice. You can add scallions to it, onions, vegetables, meat. Eating small portions of it, it takes the place of rice. Again, it's a superfood. It helps to promote weight loss, it has fiber, it helps to keep you full, and it has a lot of antioxidants to prevent cancers. Next up, we have pine nuts. These are my personal favorite. You can eat pine nuts raw or cooked. I like to eat them raw. They have that buttery finish to them. They're very soft and delicate. They add another layer of texture to your salad, so you can put it on top of a salad and put some pine nuts on there. Additionally, I also like to use pomegranate seeds. So pomegranates are another superfood. So putting some pomegranate seeds, that gives you the juiciness, the pine nuts give you that buttery finish, and that helps to improve your salad, making your lunch a little bit more enjoyable while giving you all the antioxidants that you need, fiber, and to help promote weight loss. Next up is flaxseed. You can get the flaxseed in an actual seed form. Personally, this is in my kitchen. This is the ground flaxseed, so it is powdered. Flaxseed is very good. It has about 1.8 grams of omega-3 fatty acid in it, which will help promote lowering your cholesterol, promote cardiac health to help improve your heart. Again, it has a lot of antioxidants in it and a lot of fiber to help keep you full. The trick about superfoods is you want to use them consistently throughout the day and daily if you can, hiding them into different foods that you regularly eat. For example, when I make pancakes in the morning, you add a little bit of the ground flaxseed into them, or waffles, or muffins for that matter. If I'm doing a smoothie in the morning, a blueberry smoothie, add a little bit ground flaxseed into it. That's a wonderful way to get some of these superfoods into your system. We also have brown rice. Growing up East Indian, rice is a big staple of ours. What's the difference between white rice and brown rice? Brown rice is a little bit less starchy, so I recommend it especially for diabetics. However, it takes a little bit longer to cook, so you have to be careful about that. It helps to keep you full longer. Not everyone can transition from white rice to brown rice, so if you do want to start eating brown rice, what I would recommend is for you to cook a pot of white rice and a pot of brown rice and slowly start mixing the two into your meals, eventually increasing the proportion of brown rice in your meal. Keep in mind that it does take longer to cook than white rice, so you don't want to put the two different rice grains in one pot because then you will overboil your white rice. Again, it helps to keep you full faster, promotes weight loss, and eating a smaller portion of it will help to keep you full, so you're not going to be eating as much. We have here granola. Pretty much everyone knows about granola. We eat granola in the morning. Incorporate it into your cereals in the morning. This particular granola I bought, it's ready made. It already has slivers of almond in it. Almond is another superfood. You want to be careful with almonds because they do have a high caloric intake, so you don't want to eat more than 6 to 12 almonds in one day. Granola is fantastic. Once again, add it to your cereals on top, add it to the top of muffins. Personally, I use them for parfaits. So I have, on Sundays, I have like 10 glasses. I put blueberries on the bottom, another superfood, a little bit of Greek yogurt, another superfood, and then I top it off with some granola. Put saran wrap over all those glasses, put them in the fridge, and those are perfect for your morning to-go breakfast. The granola adds a different layer of texture to the tongue, the blueberries add sweetness, and the yogurt adds a nice finish. So again, it makes your breakfast interesting, it changes up the palate, keeps you full faster, thereby decreasing your caloric intake, which is really what we're interested in when trying to have weight loss. You're not eating as much, but you're staying full. Here we have chia. Chia seeds, very soft, very delicate seeds. Chia is fantastic for the skin. It gives you a nice glowy skin, a lot of fiber, so chia again helps you to feel full. How would you use chia? The same way you would use the ground flaxseed. Incorporate it into any type of batter that you're using, so you can use it for waffles or pancakes in the morning if you're making muffins. Just sprinkle it on top of things. So if you have a salad, sprinkle some chia on top of your salad. A smoothie, sprinkle some chia on top of that. Great for your kids, they won't even realize that you're doing that, but they're getting all those antioxidants and fiber, a lot of nutrients. You can take quinoa and make quinoa bars. I forgot to mention this earlier. So this is the brown form of quinoa. Add a little bit of brown sugar to it, kind of pat it down and bake it. You get quinoa bars. Personally, my daughter loves these. These are ready made from beech nut. She doesn't know that I steal them and I eat them and give them to my staff. But they're a great snack. Again, quinoa is a superfood. It helps to keep you full faster and you get all the nutrients and antioxidant properties from it. This here is oats. We're familiar with oats. Everyone eats oatmeal in the morning. There are different types of oats. So the actual raw oats are called groats. So groats oats. The more you process oats, that's what gives them their different names. So the first level of processing is literally just taking a steel knife and cutting the oats. That gives you these. These are steel cut oats. These are probably the best ones and what I would recommend. They're not as processed, so there's a lot of nutrients in them, a lot of fiber. It takes longer to cook, however, so that's the disadvantage of them. So you would probably have to pre-cook this on Sundays, cook them out for the week if you want oatmeal, steel cut oatmeal in the morning. As you continue to process the steel cut oats, that's how you would get rolled oats. And then if you keep processing it, you get the instant oatmeal. Instant oatmeal is very fast. You add water to it, pop it in the microwave for a minute, and that gives you your oatmeal. It is time efficient, but you don't get all of the superpower nutrients that truly comes from the steel cut oats. And lastly, my favorite is cauliflower. A few years ago, all people did with cauliflower was treat it like broccoli. They cut it up, steamed it, and it was just a side on a plate. Cauliflower has really come into its own lately, especially with the paleo diets. So how else can you use cauliflower? You can really blend it up or process it. That will give you small little pieces of cauliflower, much like rice. You can then boil it and treat it like rice, so you have cauliflower rice instead of using actual rice grains. You can make fried rice with that. My personal favorite, after processing the cauliflower and getting the small little grains, mix it up with an egg, pat it down. That gives you a fantastic dough. You can then make pizza dough with it. Put your tomato sauce on top, green peppers and red peppers, and you have pizza. But instead of using flour-based dough, you have cauliflower-based dough. So it's fantastic. Again, it is a vegetable, it is fiber, it helps to keep you full faster, keeps your sugar low, keeps your caloric intake low, and keeps the weight off. So those are the main superfoods. Go out there and get it right after you're done with our diet. Try some of these new superfoods that are out there. You actually might be surprised by some of them. Many other ones that people know, they're kale, pomegranate, avocado, I mentioned the almond, spinach is another one. There's probably 50 or 60 superfoods. So go out there, do some research. So when you start eating regular foods again, incorporate these superfoods into your day daily. It'll help keep you full faster, prevent cancer, and keep you healthier. Visit us online at www.expresshealthmd.com or visit our Facebook group, Express Health MD, or our business page, Express Health AZ, and come on in anytime. Thanks for joining me in my kitchen.